Welcome to the DIA selection tool from Siemens. In this video tutorial, we want to show you how to set up a plant project that matches your requirements in just a few minutes. You can start the configuration wizard from both the portal view and the project view. Or you can use it in our browser-based solution DIA selection tool Cloud, but more about that later on. A few project properties can be defined as soon as you start the configuration wizard. Clicking on the Configure tab opens the main screen with the central navigation points. We would now like to introduce their function from top to bottom. However, when you are configuring your system, you can determine the order freely. By the way, a click on the info symbol activates the display of valuable help information. We begin our project with a Simatic S7-1200 basic controller and the ET200SP as decentralized I/O system in the cabinet. We decide on software and select Profinet as a bus system. You also indicate here whether failsafe signals are to be processed or not. Depending on cabinet size, you can specify the maximum device width and set the I/O module's desired performance reserve. Let us now turn to the central modules. Here we determine the number and type of modules that should be contained in the central S7 controller based on the required input and output signals. The function technical comparison provides help in taking your decision. Product properties can be easily compared within the same product group. Additional types of signal can be covered by add module. The addition of communication or technology modules works exactly the same way too. You remove the corresponding modules with the recycle bin icon. Finally, you can also determine which panel should be used as a control panel. Let us now focus on the distributed modules. Here too, signal type and number form the basis for the configuration, and different products can be clearly compared with each other as well as panels selected for the operation on site. The design of the distributed I/O takes place in groups. You can organize modules into units, such as process units or control cabinets. Give them corresponding names to get an even better overview. You can also copy the units. To do so, simply specify the factor per unit. Now, let's have a look at the computing power. You will now be offered the corresponding CPUs for the central controllers in line with the requirements you have made on the configuration so far. Here, you can also specify the type and size of the memory card required for the CPU. Let us now set up the interface modules, which connect the distributed ET200SP I/O system with the plant bus. Either you select the same interface globally for each distributed unit, or you match the modules individually. Clicking on Network, you can determine whether the DIA selection tool is to automatically interconnect your configured plant. To do so, select the corresponding IP address range. With CTOP power supply, the DIA selection tool will offer you suggestions for the design of your plant configuration's power supply. Only a few specifications, such as the concurrency factor, the input voltage, or the desired product line, have to be made for this. Last but not least, you can select how many software licenses you need for planning your system. If you are already using software, please enter your current versions here. As you have seen so far, the DIA selection tool considerably simplifies the structuring of a plant configuration. Conflicts are indicated if any occur during the selection. Let us increase the number of outputs in the central module to prove our point. As you can see, the number exceeds the capacity of the selected hardware. To still meet the requirements, we will now deploy our more powerful S7-1500 controller instead of the S7-1200. Now you can continue the plant configuration. Once the configuration is complete, the result is displayed with a single click. Based on your specifications, you get a clearly structured list with the required hardware. Furthermore, a concise overview is provided of the necessary signals and devices, as well as the actual signals and devices based on the requested safety reserve or performance specifications of the hardware you're using. You can now save this configuration under a new name, in a new group, or integrate it into an already existing one. However, the plant configuration is not discarded with this step to ensure your complete freedom in planning. That means you can compare all possible configurations with each other and thus find the optimal solution for your requirements. After importing a plant configuration in a project, you can generate an order list as usual and export it for your purposes. Use your login at the Industry Mall from Siemens and profit from additional benefits. The order list, for instance, immediately gives you an overview of all list prices for your first choice configuration and all alternative configurations. As mentioned before, you can also use the TIA selection tool cloud version to create plant configurations. The browser-based configuration tool is optimized for use on mobile devices. Desktop and cloud versions are identical with regard to functional scope, layout and operation. Thank you for your interest in the TIA selection tool. Check out further information at the shown internet address.
Siemens. Ingenuity for life.